from ABC News, the Weekend Report. Here's Tom Gerrold.
Good evening. There was more unrest in South Africa today as some 30,000 blacks attended funerals for victims of last week's racial violence in Uitenhage, the worst violence in a quarter of a century. Today's funerals took place after three more blacks were killed in pre-dawn confrontations with police, bringing the weekend death toll to 10. More now from Mike McCourt.
Much of the area around Port Elizabeth is now, in effect, the property of the South African Army. In response to the continuing black protests here over the killing last Thursday of 19 mourners in a funeral procession, the Army has been deployed in force. It is mainly protecting white subdivisions in the area from growing black anger. Today, the center of protest was the black township of Kwanabuli, close to the area where the 19 were killed. Six of the victims were buried amidst more and more threatening black warnings that the police in future will encounter resistance. The funerals were tense, but they passed without incident, partly because the processions were met with an immense array of police firepower. Plainclothes officers with shotguns kept the mourners confined to a single route to the black cemetery here. It is a tragic irony that these processions today were an exact replay of the funeral march last Thursday, from a black township through a white to another black. The difference this time was that the police held their fire. Mike McCourt, ABC News in Uitenhage, South Africa.
A chief critic of the Reagan administration's policy of friendly persuasion toward South Africa, Senator Lowell Weicker charged today that the present U.S. policies don't go far enough in opposing the separation of the races. But the administration's top official for African affairs, Chester Crocker, took exception to Weicker.
Our policy has been consistent. We're trying to encourage the right kind of the pattern of constructive change in South Africa. There has been some change. We see a very clear dynamic of change in that country today.
What we're trying to avoid is not to just make a vast social change. We're trying to avoid the violence which is now occurring.
South Africa's Nobel Prize winner, Bishop Desmond Tutu, criticized Pope John Paul in remarks published today. The Pope met last June with South African Prime Minister Botha. Bishop Tutu called that meeting a slap in the face for the victims of apartheid. In Los Angeles tonight, an explosion of unknown origin blew the roof off a department store filled with Sunday shoppers. At least 21 people were injured. More appeared buried beneath the rubble. At least five of the injured were critically burned and were rushed to the area hospitals for treatment. Fearing additional explosions, authorities evacuated hundreds of people from a four-block area around that store.